friends! I'm Victoria from the Ontario Science Centre, and today we're learning about pollinators and answering a couple questions about them, such as why are they so important? How do flowers work to attract them? And we'll be learning some tips on how you can help your local pollinators. But first, let's break down some terminology. Pollen are the tiny grains that are made from the stamen of a flower. They look like yellow dust. Pollination occurs when pollen is moved between two flowers of the same species.
Some flowers can even self-pollinate.
A pollinator carries pollen from one flower to another. Successful pollination results in healthy production of fruit and seeds that allow for further plant reproduction. There is a huge variety of pollinators. In fact, there are over 100,000 invertebrate species
that can pollinate. This includes bees, butterflies, moths, beetles, and flies.
There are also over 1,000 vertebrate species, including birds and bats, that also spread pollen to different plant species. In Canada, there are approximately 800 species of bees alone, making them our most common pollinator. Pollinators may be generalists, such as the monarch butterfly, that make visits to many different flowering plants. Or they may be specialists, such as the yucca moth, which visit only one species of flowering plant. Let's now discuss how plants work to attract pollinators. In fact, how about we go out into nature and make some observations for ourselves? Let's go!
Welcome to the great outdoors! Now, plants can attract pollinators based on a couple key aspects, those being flower color, petal shape, blooming time, and scent. Since most pollinators fly, flowers need to be eye-catching in order to draw attention to themselves. Different species of pollinators may see the same colors differently, and some can't see certain colors at all, but they may be drawn by other characteristics, such as scent.
Bees, like many other insects, see in the UV spectrum, so they're able to see patterns on flower petals that humans aren't even able to spot. These patterns act sort of like landing strips that help guide the pollinator to the pollen.
Next, we're going to discuss why pollinators are important. And to do so, I need some supplies for my kitchen. So let's head back to my house.
Whoa, awesome, you made it. Now, when most people hear the word pollen, they think of allergies. But in fact, pollination is an essential part of a healthy ecosystem. Without pollination, many of our native crops and flowers wouldn't be able to grow. Approximately 1,000 plants that we rely on for food and fiber need pollination. In fact, every 1 in 3 mouthfuls of food depend on pollination. Here's a spread of some food found in my kitchen.
Without pollination, I wouldn't have apples, coffee, potatoes, cucumbers, peppers, tomatoes, broccoli, carrots, onions, strawberries, or chocolate. And the list goes on. Some interesting food for thought there.
Since we depend so heavily on pollinators to help produce our food, the recent decreases in populations of butterflies, bees, and moths are a great concern. Here are 3 ways that you can get involved to help out your local pollinators. 1. In the same way that birds and other animals need water, so do our pollinators. You can help by putting out a small dish of water next to your garden, or placing some rocks in a bird bath so that the smaller pollinators have somewhere to land before they take a drink of water. 2. Plant native flowers and create a pollinator garden. Also, think about reducing your area of lawn grass, as these areas offer little food or shelter for pollinators. And 3, leave your garden messy. Many species of bees, like leafcutter bees, use garden spaces to overwinter. These bees will take refuge under a pile of bark or dried leaves, or nest cavities in decomposing logs. I hope you enjoyed learning about your local pollinators and our little trip into nature. Now it's your turn to get out there and observe. Safely, of course. Oh, and don't forget to bring along your science notebook to write down any observations of pollinators that you come across. Bye now. Thanks for joining me.